Hello, the aim of this video, which is part of the IGLUX project, is to help you write good personal summaries. As part of the work you will be asked to do at the university, you will need to produce your own summaries of basic readings. The first thing you need to know is, what is a summary? A summary is a shortened or condensed version of a text. Summaries emphasize the main ideas of a source. When writing a summary, you focus on the most important statements of the original reading. Three techniques can help you shorten the material: selection and deletion, note-taking, and reducing. A summary contains only the ideas of the original text. Do not insert any of your opinions, interpretations, deductions, or comments into a summary. And remember, it is very important that your summary is written in your own words. Now, let's prepare to write a summary. First, you need to understand the original source and its main ideas. This will include, first, the thesis or overall main idea. You will need to paraphrase it using your own words. Second, the sections into which the paper is divided. Identify the sections or divisions that the author used to organize the work. This is similar to making an outline for the reading. Third, the support used to back up the author's key points. Take note of what the authors used to support his or her statements. For instance, the most important examples, arguments, statistics, or expert opinion. Writing a summary is much easier to do from an outline. An outline will provide you with a writing plan for your summary. First, start by identifying the main idea. Then, locate and organize the supporting ideas you would like to include in your summary. There are several language structures that should be used in summaries. Some of these structures will help you avoid plagiarism and link your ideas. Useful expressions and sentence connectors. A summary is a written piece of work in which the main and supporting ideas of a text are linked. Therefore, it is crucial to use sentence connectors and other expressions, so our summary makes sense. These connectors can express different purposes. They can help you start your summary, move to other sections, connect ideas, refer to the author's ideas, and conclude your summary. These expressions can help us communicate the same idea the author does, but using our own words, which is known as paraphrasing. Paraphrasing is crucial to avoid plagiarism, but remember to always quote the original source. In this table, you can see some expressions to show similarity and contrast. Synonyms and antonyms are also useful when paraphrasing. However, when using them, you need to be careful about your choices. Not all of them work equally well in all contexts. If you need to check whether the words you want to use go together, you can search on the internet, ideally Google Scholar or language checkers. A variety of reporting verbs can be used in summary writing to render the author's viewpoint about the topic. Also, the addition of an adverb can even more clearly reveal the author's stance. In this slide, you can see some examples of reporting verbs. For instance, advance, argue, assert, etc. When writing a summary of a production that is not yours, you should quote the authors. To do so, one possibility is writing their last name followed by the year of publication of the source in brackets. After the brackets, you should add a reporting verb and the idea you want to convey. For example, Fernández claims that. In fact, if your summary is too long, you may want to mention the author's name at different points in your summary. When you mention the author in the middle or the end of your summary, be sure you use only the surname. For example, Fernández goes on to describe, or the author further argues that. You can also use these language structures in your summary to refer to the authors. Now, what do you need to write a summary? There are some useful tips when writing a summary. In the first sentence, identify the author, the title of the work, and the overall main idea. write in paragraph form and use the suitable linking words. There are also some aspects to be avoided when writing a summary. Repetition of similar ideas, minor details such as examples or descriptions, direct quotes unless there is no other way to give the information, and your own personal opinion on the subject. So now you're ready. The different steps included in the summary process will help you write a perfect summary. First, read the text as many times as you need so that you know it in great detail. The second step is to identify the most important ideas. When you have identified the main ideas, you need to locate the supporting ideas. Now you can start making your own notes and an outline of the text. Taking your outline as the starting point, write your own summary. Remember, you need to write it in your own words. And finally, don't forget to check your summary for spelling and grammar mistakes. Most word processors include these functions. So, let's recap. What do you need in a summary? As we have seen, the basic features of a summary are the following. Make sure you include them all. Did you include all the key points or main ideas? Did you report the author's ideas precisely? Did you write your summary in a clear way and divide it into coherent paragraphs? Did you mostly use your own words and put all the author's words in quotation marks? Did you check your summary to avoid spelling and grammar mistakes? If you manage to do all this, you will have surely produced a perfect summary. Congratulations! We hope that you have found this video useful. Thanks for watching. And remember, you can check our channel for more information.